Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to be reviewing, showing you before and after photos, and ultimately deciding whether or not Sun Labs Self Tanner Lotion is worth all of the hype and the positive reviews online. I have two colors that I'll be talking about today. One is called medium, one is called ultra dark, and I actually wanted to try this out because I saw a lot of positive reviews on Amazon and also customer photos of girls just looking beautiful and like golden goddesses while wearing this. And the company reached out to me and asked if I wanted to try the self tanner. I was like, wow, that's my perfect opportunity to do that. So I actually got one of these bottles sent to me for free, the color medium, but then I actually liked it so much I went ahead and I bought the color ultra dark with my own money. So I want to give you guys a quick disclaimer. One of the products was sent to me, or one color was sent to me, and then one color I actually ended up getting because I liked it. This video is not sponsored though. I am giving you my personal opinion. I was not obligated to make this video at all, and this product was just sent to me, no strings attached, just to try it out. Sun Labs have multiple formulations of tanners, including lotions, mousses, and sprays, and I have the lotion type specifically. If you want a spray or a mousse, they do offer that, but I have the lotion. And this is 8 ounces for $20. That's like the standard price. This product does go on sale though, so if you're like, I do want to try it out, but I don't want to spend $28, you may be able to find this on Amazon today's deals, or like flash deals, whatever that's called. As far as the colors, I do have two colors. One was sent to me. It was the medium color right here, and it's also called Tan Overnight Medium. Tan Overnight's right here, medium's on the bottom. Then I also got the color ultra dark, and it says ultra dark right here, but then when I went on the website, ultra dark was actually dark on the bottom. Like, it didn't say ultra dark, it just said dark on the bottom, and I assumed this was the darkest color they offered, but it's not. The darkest color I believe is called Dark Sun Station, and on the bottom it says very dark, so it's a little bit confusing. But I guess if it says ultra dark here, that's technically like the medium shade. Medium is technically the lightest, and the absolute darkest shade they offer at the moment is Dark Sun Station, and it says very dark on the bottom. Alright, so the claims of this product, I'm gonna read you right off the bottle here. It says, made with natural ingredients, fast drying, paraben free for all skin types. So as far as made with natural ingredients, that's true. I looked on the back. It's got vitamin C, it's got sweet almond oil, and a few other ingredients that are like pronounceable and you know what they are. Though it does have those nice ingredients in it, it's not like a fully all natural organic type of a product. It does have some like fragrance and yellow 6 and red 40 and blue 1 and all those kinds of chemicals in it. If you're really curious about it, I'm sure you can see the list of the ingredients in this guy on the website, but I did not have any problems with irritating my skin or anything like that. Also on the website, it says that color is instant and will intensify in 3 hours, and on the packaging here does say to avoid contact with water for at least an hour after application. And that's totally true, because if you do like spill a little bit of water on yourself, or if you get even a drop of water on your freshly tanned skin, it will like stain, but reverse stain. Instead of becoming darker, that water spot is going to lift and lighten up, so you're gonna have like a light dot on your arm if you get it on your arm or whatever you get it. Okay, so the packaging I really do like a lot. There's really nothing too crazy about it. It's just a pump applicator, but it does also come with a closable cap like this, which if you want to open it, you just press on this guy here and then it opens up, and then you can close it right back up. But I love, love, love this because you can travel with this self tanner. I have not tried traveling with this myself, although I am going to Chicago in a couple weeks, so I'm going to take this with me. But I have tried traveling with like a mousse self tanner, you know, the kind that has like a pump and the cap, and that is not the best thing in the world at all. It spills everywhere, it leaks. You literally have to like stuff things in there and then like put it in a bunch of bags, and it still leaks everywhere. It's just a big mess. But I love, love, love the fact that this little guy comes with the packaging here. It's such a small thing, but it really does make a difference. So with the self tanner, you also get an applicator mitt, which is an okay mitt. I wouldn't say it's like the best one I've ever used in my entire life, but it does get the job done. So if you don't have one and you're like, do I need to get a separate one, It does come with the self tanner, but if you want, you know, a special one or whatever one you want, then you might want to get an extra one, but it does come with this product. So now let's talk about the consistency of this product and how it applies. I was actually really surprised by both of those things. The first is it's actually a dark lotion, like it's a genuinely dark lotion, and every other lotion I've tried that was a self tanner lotion, obviously, was a light color, like a basic white color, and it would eventually turn dark. And this one is already dark, which is actually a good thing. It doesn't really seem like a good thing, but it is, because you know where you're applying this. If you're applying a lotion that does not have a color, you kind of don't know how much you applied and where, and sometimes you do miss spots. Like, you can kind of go about it and do an okay job, but I think it's better that you can see where you've applied this, and with this one you definitely can. And as far as the consistency of this, it's unlike any other lotion I've tried, because it is a light gel-like lotion, but then it's still a lotion. So you can use a mitt with the self-tanner, which you really can't use a mitt with like a true lotion self-tanner, because the mitt gets all like cloggy and it starts dragging the product and like it doesn't really blend well. So if you're using a lotion self-tanner, I typically would use my hands to spread it, which is not my favorite thing in the world, because your hands get all dirty and it's not like the most efficient even application. But with this product, you can totally use a mitt and it works like a charm. And it's also like a light spreadable, liquidy-ish but not too runny consistency, that it is so easy to work with. It does not tend to like stick to dry areas. It blends over them pretty well, and it's just like such an easy, awesome formula to work with. It does go okay on hands and feet if you don't apply any lotion underneath, which is pretty incredible, but I still apply a little bit on my hands and my feet. If you're using a mousse, you almost like absolutely have to apply some sort of a lotion there, but if you're using this guy here, you don't have to, but if you really want to be like extra careful, you can, and I do. It's just an awesome formula. I was really shocked. Like, I wanted to try it because it had so many good reviews, but I really did not have such high hopes for it. But the consistency and the formula just totally blew me away. And the cap. One more thing I want to mention before I forget is the smell. The smell totally shocked me as well, because it's like a stronger perfumey smell, but it does not really smell like a self-tanner. So if you do not like a self-tanner smell, this one here really doesn't smell like a self-tanner to me at all. What it does smell like, though, is either almond extract or cherries. I cannot decide which one it is, but I feel like it might be cherries, though I am smelling almond extract, so I'm not sure, but it smells like one of those two things. So like I said, it is a darker color. It goes on really dark, and once you apply it, it does feel like a little bit tacky, but not as tacky as I would expect a lotion product to feel like. It almost feels like a mousse does, like a mousse tanner does when you apply it. You know how like, even though it's a liquid product, mousse tanners do have a slight tackiness to them after you apply them on your skin, and this lotion almost feels like a mousse once you've spread it into your skin and like let it dry for a minute or so. I don't find it to like crease. I don't find it to move or budge throughout the night, because I do apply this in the evening before going to bed, and then the next morning I do wash it off. It does, however, stain. So if you have like white bed sheets or just don't want this to stain anything, I would recommend wearing like clothes before you go to bed, or just, you know, just know that it does stain things. It's not as bad at staining things as some other self-tanners I've tried, but it's definitely the kind that will. And you do also want to wash this off before putting on nice clothes, because again, it is going to stain them. But my routine again is just applying this before going to bed, sleeping with this on, letting it develop for about 8 hours. I don't think you actually have to let this sit on the skin for that long, but I, you know, I'm sleeping, so I'm not gonna wake up in the middle of the night and take this off. And then in the morning, I just wash this off and I'm good to go. It does say on the packaging the color is instant and will intensify in 3 hours. You could let this sit for potentially 3 hours and wash it off. I've never tried leaving it on for so little, and honestly, when self-tanners say to leave it on for like 2 hours, it's usually best that you leave it on for a little longer, because they just develop darker if you're okay with that. Apply before you go to bed, and then wake up and take a shower. You'll be good to go. And actually, let me just go ahead and show you the photos of what my skin looked like before the self-tanner, then what it looked like with one coat of the self-tanner on, and then what it looked like when I applied it the next day, the second coat, basically. So we have no self-tanner, one coat, and two coats. This color is buildable, so if you want like a darker tan and the first time you apply this, it's not as dark as you want it to be, you can totally apply it again the next night and the next night, and it will intensify and build build up, which I love. And in fact, I do apply my self-tanner about twice a week to kind of upkeep and build up that tan. The medium color is nice. It is lighter than the ultra dark, obviously. And though I don't mind the medium color, I do prefer a slightly darker ultra dark color. But again, you can still build up the medium color. So if you want like a lighter tan, still like a nice tan, definitely like a tan, but a lighter tan, medium color is good. But if you want like a slightly more intense, a darker tan, then ultra dark might be a better option, or the one I mentioned earlier, which I don't have, which is Dark Sensation. The last thing I want to talk about is the color of the self tanner, because obviously that's important as well. And the color of the self tanner is orangey red. It's not so orange that it looks fake, but it's definitely like that kind of a color. Like if you see on my skin, it's not like olivey, it's not blue or purple, it's just self-tanny color, but it also has enough red in it that makes it look a bit more natural, a bit like your skin is kind of like red from all the sun that you're getting or the fake tan that you're applying. So to summarize all of my rambling, I want to just quickly list a few things I love and a few things I don't like about this product, and then ultimately tell you whether or not I think it is worth it. So what I really like about this product is formula, how easy it goes on the skin, how spreadable and buildable and non-patchy it is as a self-tanner. I love the packaging, which is kind of silly, but trust me, when you travel with poor self-tanner packaged product, you really appreciate good packaging, and this one is fine. Again, I've never traveled with it, but this cap is just awesome. And I also really like the smell. It's either almonds or cherries, but it's a nice smell and it's not a self-tanner smell. I also like the color, but as far as the intensity of the color, I would definitely recommend you guys checking out either the ultra dark or the sensation. I keep forgetting what that's called. Sensational? Dark Sensation, that's the color. Basically, the dark or the very dark color. The medium is fine as well for those of you who are paler and just want a bit of a self-tan, but not too much. And again, you can build this color up as well because I have tried this specific self-tanner. The thing I don't like about it though is the price. It is $28 for 8 ounces, which is not that cheap. But again, it is on sale sometimes on Amazon. So if you just keep on checking the today's deals, you will see this there fairly frequently. Like I've seen it at least twice already, and I really do think you'll enjoy using this if you do get it. So that is it for my video. I hope you guys found this helpful. Thank you so much for all of your sweet comments and all the support that I get from you guys. I hope you're having a wonderful day, and I do hope to see you in the next video. Bye.